You know how we made something look like a box in the last talk through by making this div and then giving it a background color? Well, actually, every element on your web page is considered a box by the browser, whether or not it looks like a box to you. This heading is a box, this paragraph is a box, even the span that we made is a box. Some of the boxes are big, some are small, some are in line, like the span. Some are block, like the div, but they're all considered boxes. Why does this matter? Because of something called the box model, which you can see in the diagram I just pasted in. Every element's box has four parts: the actual content, the padding, the border, and the margin. We can use CSS to modify the padding, border, and margin, so you'll understand soon what those really are. Let's start with the margin. That's the transparent area around the box that separates the box from other elements. We'll specify margin using our favorite unit, pixels. To add 15 pixels of margin on every side of the official info box, we can just write margin 15 pix. See the change that made? What if we want a different amount of margin on each side, like more on the top bottom than the left right? We can write those amounts in clockwise order, starting from the top. So top 15 pics, right 0 pics, bottom 10 pics, left 6 pics. Or we can use specific properties for each side, if we only want to specify a few sides. Like if we want to have some space around the cat picture on the right, and then we also just want some on the bottom, and we're happy to have the default margin for the other sides. There's also a special value for margin that will help us do something fancy with our pages. To show you that, I'm going to add a div around the entire page, give it an ID of container. Let's put this tag here so it contains everything. Now, I'm going to add a rule for that div to give it a width of 400 pics. And I want to center it on the page. I could specify a margin left 100 pixels because that looks centered to me, but it may not look centered to you because your browser might be bigger or smaller. What we want is to be able to say, give it however much margin it needs so that it's got equal margin on both sides. That is exactly what margin auto does. And it's a great way to center divs on a page. Now that we've centered that div, we might want to make it even more distinct by adding a border around the edge of it using the CSS border property. Let's add a red border to that div. We type border, and then we need to specify three aspects of the border: thickness, style, and color. For a thin border, we can just type 1 pix. For a solid line, nothing fancy, we'll just type solid. And to make it red, I'll pop on my RGB color picker and pick a nice fiery red. Okay. Just like with margin, we can specify the border for just like one side. Like if we want a really thick purple border on the top, we'll add another property. Border top 10 pics solid purple. Cool. Now let's add a frame to the image and play around with border styles. So going up to our cute cat, let's see, border 6 pics. Let's try groove red. Okay, no, I don't like groove. Let's try double. Let's try ridge. Aha, now that looks like a frame. Okay, how about a border around our official info? Let's see, border, let's not make it too big, 2 pixels. Let's try dotted, and then let's pick just a subtle gray. Let me try dashed instead. Okay, that's what I want. Now with all these borders, something is bothering me a little. Actually, something's bothering me a lot. See how the text is butting up next to the border in the container and butting against the text in the official info? That's so gross looking, and it makes it harder to read the text. That is where padding comes in. Whenever your elements have background colors or borders, you'll almost always want to add padding to put a bit of space between the contents and the edges. Let's add some padding to the container. Let's do 15 pics all around the container. Oh, so much better. Let's add some padding to our official info. Let's see, padding, 6 pixels. Oh, beautiful. Now, we don't need to add padding to the image since images actually look good inside frames like that. And there you have it, the box model. Margin, border, and padding. I used big values and bright colors to show them off to you, but my page does look a bit cheesy now. If you want your page to look sleek and sophisticated, try using more subtle whites and grays. Whatever you do, make sure you use these properties because you'll have a big effect on how your page looks and feels.